Hi, this is Siri from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're looking at something really special, something I've been looking for years now, ever since the first kind of regular sized or full sized Koenig Aries has come out. And I have done an unboxing of this knife. You will see that linked in the top right corner, and there you can see kind of my first impressions on the knife. And today we're going to do a full review of this mini Aries. This is a modified one. This was one of the regular kind of flipper tab versions of the Koenig Aries, and this was modified to have a flipper delete. Now that I'm recording this in November 2023, there are actually factory versions without a flipper available from Koenig knives, or have been available. They are always kind of sold out, and there you can see a bit of a difference in the Ricasso area on the factory flipper delete versions. But this is a kind of aftermarket modded flipper delete mini Aries of the first batch that they ever did, where we had blue anodized accents, just plain silver accents, and these bronze accents available. It's also mentioned here on the inside, it says batch 1, generation 1, G1B1 right in there. So one of the first mini Arises that was available, and I was able to get this on the secondary market. And they mention on the website that the price should be $650. I don't know if that's actual table price at the moment, but usually these go for quite a bit more on the secondary market. But that's always the case with these kind of limited quantity custom knives. And I think overall the quality is absolutely there, and I'm super happy that I actually have this one here in the collection. If you like my video so far and my other content, please consider a subscription and put all your comments in the comment section below. I will answer and read everything. And you can also follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews for some more content like this. And also be sure to check out the description of all my videos for some links and interesting information. So before we go any further, do some comparisons and things like that, let's get the specs out of the way. So this is the mini Aries, the smaller version. You can see it was built on August 17th of 2023. It has a 20 CV burnished blades with polished flats. And it is the smooth titanium version. Now they already have released some textured titanium versions, which this one is not. Overall length on the mini Aries, we have here 18.5 centimeters or 7.28 inches with a blade length of 7.5 centimeters or 2.95 inches. The cutting edge is going to be a bit less because of the forward finger trail right there of 6.8 centimeters or 2.67 inches. Of 20 CV blade steel, and we have a blade stock of around 3 millimeters, so nothing special there. We have a hollow ground blade, and we have the polished flats, as you have seen on this certificate of authenticity. It's more of a kind of hand satin flat, I would say. And then you got this very nice kind of high reflectivity stone wash, very nicely done there, nice and thinly hollow ground blade. Good and functional tip. We got this kind of hollow ground swatch that also has the kind of stonewashed finish on it. Really well done there. No jimping on this blade anywhere. Absolutely gorgeous overall design, just the same as on the full-sized areas, just shrunken down. Then hand length, we're looking at 11 centimeters or 4.33 inches. And then we have a weight of 92 grams or 3.25 ounces. That's also achieved by having nice internal milling. The prototype ones had this milling kind of on the outside, but you can see some nice chunks are taken out of both sides of the titanium handle here on the mini Aries. So that's really, really well done. And other than that, it's just an absolutely great size. You know, I have a 7.5 sterile glove hand in the kind of regular choke back position. It fits well. Of course, there's not a lot of handle kind of hanging over, but it's very comfortable to hold it in a regular saber grip like that. And now that I have the flipper delete, I can also go into the foregrip. I don't have very thick fingers, so if you have thicker fingers, maybe the factory flipper deletes that kind of extend that a little bit more are more your cup of tea. But for me, it worked perfect like that as well. Of course, in a hammer grip, it's also very comfortable. You're really close to that cutting edge, but you can do some work. And it's just an absolutely gorgeous design. And I think they sized it down just enough to make it work with kind of most hand sizes, in my opinion. I really like it. And I'm very impressed with how they executed here this mini version. It took a lot of time. I think these were teased quite a couple of years ago. But now they are finally here and they are developing all of the things they have done with the larger Koenig areas with the mini here as well over the coming years for sure. So there's lots of stuff to actually look forward to. But of course, availability with these knives is always a bit of an issue because they can only produce so many. And these are kind of CNC machine custom knives made in the US, very close in kind of the operation and feel to a Shirogorov, in my opinion. It runs on ceramic bearings, and you see the action is absolutely impressive. And because the middle finger flick works so great, I didn't see the need for the flipper tab. Also because it's a quite fat flipper tab when you actually see it, and it kind of destroyed the whole kind of look of the design for me personally. I think in this way, without the flipper tab, it looks absolutely gorgeous, like a race car or something. Really, really well done. And it's just also performance-wise absolutely great. Nothing gets in the way. It's nice and slicey and just has a great overall size. Now, let's take a look at some size comparisons here to the mini areas. First, we have our standard ones. Here we have the Elementum Button Lock 2, which is very close in overall size. And then we have the CJRB Pyrite, which is also really close. So a great EDC-sized folder here with the Koenig areas. And then some other high-end options that you might consider when considering a Koenig areas. Here we have the small Sebenza 21 with an Insingo blade, which is slightly smaller. Then we have the Shirogorov Neon Zero, which is slightly larger, and of course a dedicated flipper. Then we have the Arnaud Bernard iMamba, which is probably size-wise a bit closer to the full-size areas. And then we have another kind of hyped knife, the Rosewald by OZ Machine Company, which is very close in overall size actually, but a much flatter overall design, not as contoured as the mini areas. And then last but not least, we have the Skiff Drifter, also a gorgeous CNC machine custom out of the US, which is slightly larger, as you can see. If you take a look at thickness as a comparison, for example, with the Rosewald, we can see that it is slightly thicker than the Rosewald, but of course, it also has these very nicely contoured handle scales. If you take a look at the finish of the titanium, we can see it's a pretty kind of standard finish, but there are some micro milling lines, or maybe these are just kind of leftover machining marks on this kind of blasted handle, but it actually looks pretty good, even though it probably are just machining marks, but it really looks quite nice. And overall, the fit and finish on this knife, all the chamfers and everything, is done really well. Here we can see the titanium backspacer with the lanyard hole. It also has these kind of slots, so your lanyard would go kind of straight and have not your kind of lanyard material bundle up here on the sides. That's always a good little thing. Also, access to the lock bar is very well done. Absolutely no issue right there. Got the jimping here on the lock bar. And just the action is insane, considering it's completely solid in terms of lockup. We got a stainless steel lock bar insert with an over travel stop. Also appreciate how thin the actual lock bar cutout is. If you compare that, for example, to something like a Sebenza, these are just leaps and bounds. So nicely done here on the thin lock bar cutout. Ergonomically, as I said before, very, very comfortable clip. I really like the kind of window clip, but they took that from the original large one. It looks very nice. It is a hidden hardware clip. It could be mounted a bit higher for my preference, but about this much is going to stick out of your pocket. It works actually quite well. It has some nice springiness to it. It worked with all of my pants, so nothing to complain there on the mini areas pocket clip for me personally. It's also not too large. They kind of sized it down appropriately, which was always a good thing. If you go with a mini, also please size down your clips. That's really a good thing to do. Also, in terms of ambidextrous manipulation here of the left hand, it works actually pretty much the same for manipulating that hole and the lock bar. It's just a very, very cool knife. The overall price range at $650, I think it's a great deal. Also, at some of the slightly higher aftermarket prices, I can certainly see this guy being worth it. It's a great design, really. It's one of the best kind of USA-made higher production or kind of CNC custom knives available. And I think of all of the different models that will be coming out, this could be an absolutely great knife. And I think in this size, it will have much more kind of fans that actually do carry and use it, because I think the original Arias was actually quite a large and heavy knife, but with this kind of size down version, I think it's absolutely EDC carryable. You also have the nicely done Koenig logo there, very understated, and especially the Flipper Delete model is absolutely where the money's at, and I think this is probably one of the nicest releases from this year. Certainly a contender for knife of the year here for 2023. For me personally, absolutely gorgeous, great action, great cutting performance, absolutely gorgeous look, and very well done pocket clip, a nice and lightweight for its size, and just the overall feel of manipulation is so buttery smooth, perfectly centered. It's just a super well-made, well-sized, geniusly designed folder, and I think they took the time they needed to make it as perfect as it is right now. And just one thing to know, if you get one, go for a Flipper Delete model. If you have thinner fingers, I think the kind of aftermarket Flipper Deletes are pretty well suited for you, but if you have a bit thicker fingers, larger hands, I probably would go for a factory Flipper Delete, so you have a little bit more room in this area right here. So this was my full review of the Koenig Arias Mini. Absolutely a fan of it. Really cool knife. One of my best acquisitions of this year. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.